Good morning. Good to see you all. Thanks for carving out some time and being with me this morning. So I have some things that are on my heart today that I'd like to talk with you about. And so I'd like to talk about a couple of topics in particular, about the topic of reading scripture and praying. Reading scripture and praying. And so I want to walk down through here and get to my classroom and talk with you a little bit about that. So there are some scriptures that come to mind when I think about this idea of reading scripture and praying. And one is found in 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16 and 17. It says, all scripture is inspired by God and profitable for correction, for instruction, for reproof, instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. And other scriptures that kind of bring to mind this, the importance of reading scripture daily, continually. One is Psalm 119, 105, that says, thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. A couple others, Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12 says, and the word of God is sharper than any two-edged sword, even to divide the soul from the spirits, the joints from the marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Reading scripture. And then, of course, in Matthew chapter 4, talks about man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of the Lord. So reading scripture is part of this formula. And the second half of this formula is praying. And so we know in 1 Thessalonians, it says actually to pray always, pray without ceasing. And we know that in Philippians chapter 4, 6 and 7, verse 6 and 7 says this, have no anxiety about anything, but in everything by prayer with supplication, make your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all comprehension, will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. And so we know that the disciples, when they were with Jesus, they said, Lord, teach us to pray. Teach us to pray. And the Lord said, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. So, reading scripture and praying. So that's going to be kind of our topic today. And then I have an acronym behind me on the wall, a LEAD, and it's going to stand for some ways to have this word that we read come alive in our life, and this prayer life that we participate in come alive in our life as well. But before that, so today we're going to have scripture, and I want to share a song with you, and then a story. So let's get started with this song, and it's about always reading scripture and praying. So this is how it goes. You know there's a lock that goes by the front door. Don't forget the one who is the way. Childhood faith says, always read scripture and pray. go to church cause you really want to. Visit grandma every chance that you can. It won't be a wasted day, so always read scripture and pray. Holy Ghost, say please, say thank you. Don't fear, don't steal, and don't stray. I know you've got mountains to climb, but always read scripture and pray. When the dreams you're dreaming come to you, when the work you put in is realized, let the Lord get the praise and always read scripture and pray. Don't expect a free ride from no one. Don't hold a grudge or a chip, and here is why. Bitterness keeps you from flying. Always read scripture and pray. Know the difference between saying you love God and truly loving Him with all that you got. I love you ain't no empty phrase, so always read scripture and pray. Hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't fear, don't steal, and don't stray. I know you've got mountains to climb, but always read scripture and pray. When the dreams you're dreaming come to you, when the work you put in is realized, let the Lord get the praise and always read scripture and pray. When it's hot, eat a root beer popsicle. Shut off the AC and roll the windows down. And grab a space by yourself and always read scripture and pray. Take for granted the love the Lord gives you. When you get where you're going, don't forget to turn back around and help the next one today to always read scripture and pray.